And that would be the Detroit Lions. Went 5-11 last year, had a coaching change. Matt Patricia goes back to the Patriots for basically a bag of chips. And they needed help basically everywhere. They went and got Jared Goff. They traded away Matt Stafford in the offseason. Got some picks. Got, you know, whatever. They needed wide receiver, I guess, linebacker, quarterback, cornerback, safety. You know, they needed dudes. And really anything in this situation would have been fine. They were trying to establish a culture under MCDC, Motor City Dan Campbell. And I will go ahead and tell you, before I read off these names, I love what they did because I can see the strategy. It's the old school way of going about it, but I like what they did. First round, offensive tackle Penei Sewell out of Oregon fits their mentality perfectly. Second round, interior defensive lineman Levi Onwuzurike out of Washington. Oof. I hope I said that right. That's a tough name. But he's the one that came in and he was like, I just like hitting people in the face.
He said, I just like hitting people in the face. Which there's is awesome. No doubt he was going to be a Detroit Lion when he said that.
Third round, they got Aleem McNeil out of NC State, who plays the exact same way. Third round again, Ifeatu Melifonwu out of Syracuse. Another guy, cornerback, that plays, you know, tough. Really tough player. Fourth round, wide receiver Amon-Ra St. Brown out of USC. They needed wide receiver help. I think he's going to help with that. I think he fell quite a bit. Linebacker Derek Barnes out of Purdue in the fourth round. And seventh round flyer, they took running back Jamar Jefferson out of Oregon State. And he is a speedster. He's a small dude, but he packs a wallop when he hits you. And Chris, we watched him multiple times. You remember us sitting in the sports book watching them against Oregon State, and he was at that point, we thought the best player on the field. I mean, he was ridiculous. He looked better than Chuba Hubbard did. That was the beginning of, like, the 2019 season. He was unbelievable. I like what they did. I can see the strategy. I don't know that what they're doing is the way that the NFL is going now, but I think when everybody else is zigging and you decide to zag, I think that can be beneficial. I like what Dan Campbell and that bunch did.
Yeah, and look, they have a need at every single position on the field. They're not settled at anything outside of maybe the young running back, DeAndre Swift, who still seems to have a little bit of health issues, but that's it. And this team has no wide receivers. I mean, nothing. So I was a little surprised they didn't try to get a playmaker early. Obviously, they didn't bring back Kenny Golladay. They were really strange at the end of last year. Like, we want to give some of these young receivers help. Then they release Marvin Hall, who is a terrific young receiver and a really nice pickup. I believe he went to Washington, or did he go to Cleveland? One of those two. And then they sign Mohamed Sanu. I'm like, wait a second. That's not the young guy that we're so I don't know who the hell Jared Goff's going to throw the football to. Quintez, but it is no Cephas, secret that they
– Tyrell Williams, Breshad Perriman. I can't believe you're not a Perriman fan. I mean, my goodness. No,
you kidding me? Breshad Perriman? I know he had the year with Jameis in Tampa Bay. What the hell ever? I mean, this is going to be a bad team, and there's no way they were going to be able to fix everything right here. So I do like that they addressed this from the inside out because the team could not stop the run last year. They couldn't block for Matthew Stafford. You know, Stafford's one of the toughest dudes in the league, and he's going to play hurt no matter what. And he was hurt no matter what because that line couldn't stop anyone from smashing him. And, I mean, they just can't stop anyone anywhere. So I do like the strategy. I like getting Penei Sewell. A lot of people had him going as high as 5 to Cincinnati, so you get him a couple picks later. Lord knows you got to protect Jared Goff because we're talking about moving on from untrustworthy quarterbacks. The Rams did the right thing in getting rid of Jared Goff. He's an absolute bust, and it's going to be a long year for Lions fans watching him throw to Tyrell Williams and Breshad Perriman. Oh, TJ Hockenson will not be on my tight end radar for fantasy football next year.
Typically, you've got an idea of who the backup quarterbacks are. Do either of y'all know who the backups are?
Jared Goff. Is it Chase Daniel? I don't know.
Chase Daniel's still in Tampa Bay.
Oh, okay, Tampa Bay. Okay.
No. Blaine Gabbert's in Tampa Bay, isn't he?
I'm about to say Blaine Gabbert.
Yeah. Blaine Gabbert. Okay, now I have no idea where
somewhere. He's somewhere. Chicago, maybe?
He's made a lot of money.
He was in New Orleans, but he's not now.
It's Tim Boyle, who was the he just came in from Green Bay, and David Blau, who came in from Cleveland. He was like,
as a Thanksgiving Day savior 2 years ago, David Blau was a DFS monster that day. Came out and threw two early touchdowns on Thanksgiving Day. I was very happy with David Blau. Overall, I think they did the right thing here. Build inside out. This is going to take a few years to get things right in Detroit. Of course, they still need a quarterback. They need weapons on the offensive side of the ball. But the defense was so awful last year. I like that they went defensive tackle rounds 2 and 3. Get yourself a staple on that offensive line of Penei Sewell. So overall, winning grade here, I would say for Detroit. I still think they need playmakers though.
Chase Daniels is in L.A. with the Chargers.
There you go.
Oh well, there you go.
Just
collecting checks again.
Yeah, nice.
There you go. Just collecting checks, man.
Just collecting checks.
Yeah, I like what this team did. I'm with you, and they have a ton of holes. I don't know that it equates to wins this year. There's a chance that in 3 years, what they did this year is going to matter. It's going to be important. And when we look back in 3 years, we'll say that's where the foundation started. If that team can get to a above 500, level of football, they still have a lot of holes and they still need a lot of needs. But Gary, you and I talk about this all the time, Kyle. We believe that the way you build a team is from the front seven out on both sides of the line. That's exactly what they're doing. And I respect that. I appreciate that. If you get that foundation of guys, finding receivers, finding running backs, finding DBs is easy. Okay. Finding a quarterback is very hard, but you can run. I mean, we've seen not good quarterbacks make playoffs all the time. And so you can get there with somebody who's well below average as long as you built the rest of the team.
Baker Mayfield. I mean, we just saw it with Cleveland, right? I'm just kidding.
That's okay. No, listen, I'm messing with you. You don't have to apologize. Look, I don't hate Baker anymore. I did. But I don't herald him as the savior. Okay. I just don't. So
right.
Chase, a little nugget I'm going to spend 30 seconds on this. Chase Daniels with the Saints for 3 years, with the Chiefs for 3 years, with the Phillies for a year, back with the Saints for a year, with Chicago for 2 years, with Detroit, and now with...
Okay, so he was in Detroit. I was like, I knew he was there sometime.
No, he was there last year.
Okay, yep. Okay, good.
Right. I'm trying to last look year? Up. He has made $37.8 million, and he has thrown a total of 261 passes in the NFL.
Yeah. Doesn't he get like $3 million per touchdown, or like $10 million per touchdown pass in the NFL? Something crazy like that.
Yeah, he's had eight touchdown passes. So
Chase Daniel, that's how you do it, there. That's how it's done.
You stay up.
Breaking news right now: Penei Sewell just tested positive for COVID.
Oh my god! Well,
what are the chances that it just came across?
That is ridiculous. Let's see. I am all right. 37.8 million. Whatever. Divided by, let's see, 261 passes. That is that's about almost $150,000 a pass.
Oh my god! Even the incomplete ones. Think about that. You just throw in the dirt. You throw a pick. I just got $150,000 for that. Oh, that's how you do it. That guy is hustling at life. That's called winning. I love Chase Daniel now.
So overall, I think we all like what the Lions are doing. It's different. It's different than what everybody else is doing. Sometimes that can work in your favor. So they still they need a lot of help, but I think this was a good draft to kind of get them headed in the right direction. So props to MCDC gnawing some kneecaps off. We are all fans of that. Is there anything else that we need to hit on for today's teams?
That's it.
That is
it. Get your Brown Super Bowl tickets now. It's going to be the best odds you're going to get.
Oh, my God. All right, let's get out of here. Go follow Kyle on YouTube. You can find his channel, DFS Bachelor. You can find him on Twitter, the same spot, at DFS Bachelor. You can find us at winningcureseverything.com. And, again, sbrpicks.com/NCAAF, NFL, and MLB. Very simple to do. You can also find it, I think, at sportsbookreview.com, whatever you want to do. So go check that stuff out. Gentlemen, I appreciate you all being here today, and we have one more day to go tomorrow. We are hitting the AFC and NFC East, and certainly not the least, I would say, but we had to wait all the way till Thursday to hear Chris's remarks about his Patriots. But I'm excited about it. You know, he gets to talk about some Alabama players, so I'm pumped.
Oh, yeah, he loves those Alabama players.
You better believe it.
Roll Tide, roll.
Roll Tide.
All right. I don't actually agree with that.
What a ridiculously dumb saying.
It is a dumb saying.
That would absolutely come out of Alabama, no doubt.
I'm so tired of watching people go, why don't you watch the Alabama game on Saturday? I'm like, well, they're playing Northeast McNeese State, and they're going to beat them 940-0. Like, no, I only want to watch them play Clemson.
Team.
Yeah, exactly. Just beat the living crap out of them with no guilt whatsoever. Just shameful.
Oh, wait a minute. Shameful, no, they'll go play a Power 5 team. Oh, listen, bring in Duke. Let's kick your shit out of them. We play playing Duke. You know, we played an ACC team. What are you talking about?
Poor Gary. We're just
I love you guys, but I hate you all the same. So so we'll end with the Roll Tide, but we'll also tell you, take care of yourself, take care of each other, and hopefully all your tickets cash this week. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.